Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on how you can use SwiftUI basically in your UIKit app. Yeah, you heard that right, SwiftUI in UIKit. Well, with the help of a DuckUI. So without further ado, let's jump right into today's episode. Today we are going to talk about frames, width and height. So really exciting tutorial about how you can set your elements, your views, frame, width or height. Or rather just let's jump right into the code and see how that looks like. Now in the previous one we have been talking about stacks and we have added these hello DuckUI label, and let me just build and run, and we have also added a debug here so we can see all of the intrinsic content size of our label currently, or basically the frame. So this is really nice visual feedback here. We can remove that in a production app, of course. And today we are going to tinker with the frame. And to do that, let me just create a brand new view, because there are simple views, there are stack views, and there's everything else. So let me just go ahead and create a simple view here, and that will be a simple UI view. Okay, and let's just add a debug here. So we are just going to debug it, or rather yet, let's see. Yeah, let's just debug it. Okay, and in the horizontal stack, if you wanted to add a debug, let's just add debug. So just so you know, in DuckUI, there are kind of three things that you need to know about, and that can be added as chainable. So we are going to have views, stack views, and everything else. So let me just explain. When you add a view here, so let's add our view here. No, not the view, a simple view. Just copy this out. So when we add our simple view here, okay, so here we have our simple view, and some methods vary for UI views and for other stuff like labels or buttons. And let me just give you an example here. Okay, so simple view, not let's say background, and you can see it's called set background color, and let's set in here a red. And if we go to the label and just start typing in, you can see that when it returns a UI label, it's just calling background, let's say dot red again. So these are some minor changes, or rather we had differences in the syntax, but you get the point. With basically UI views, you kind of always use set or add, and the rest besides stack views, because yeah, with stack views I try to use add, like here, add debug. With the rest is just background, frame, and so on. So yeah, that's just that. So you know about a little bit more about the syntax, but let's take a look at the frame. And the frame is something that is returning always a UI view. And yeah, let's just add in here set frame. And yeah, let's see, cg size, and yeah, I'm just going to use this as 100 by let's say 200. It doesn't really matter. Okay, and for that, let's just build and run and see how this looks, and maybe add a debug here so we can basically see what we are adding, because the simple view has simple background of clear. Okay, and there it is. Here we have our simple view, and because we added our debug to our vertical stack, we have this green debug here. So why we just maybe let's just add this to our horizontal stack. So there we go. just add it there. Okay, now let's add our label a frame. So set frame, and let's see, CG size. Maybe you want to do this, maybe you don't. I will just show you how it is done. So let's add in here 200 by, let's say, 300. I don't know, maybe it makes sense to you, but maybe not. All right, yet. Let's add a debug too here. So let's add in here, a debug. So a dot, where is it? Yes, dot debug. There we go. Hit Command R. Finally, now we will be able to see that the DuckUI, so the simple label, is pushed to be of width 200 and of course of height 300. So yeah, that is basically it, and that's frame. So you can set the frame, but you most probably don't want to set the frame. Those are really, really edgy cases when you want to set the frame. But rather you want to set the width or the height of your elements. And that is pretty simple too. So let's delete this set frame and just start typing in, let's say, width here. So simple view, set width, and let's see, 300. And let's delete for now the frame for our UI label. So let's hit Command R to build and run again. So yeah, that is a width. Yeah, we have pushed really, really hard out there. So let's have only 100. Okay, so these are arbitrary. You will see use cases in your own app. So there we go. Here we have our 100 width. Okay, maybe let's have this for our label. So if you type in width, you will have, let's say, 100. You might not want to have a set of width to your code, but it depends. It depends. What do you want to have? Maybe you have only one line of code and you want to have those three lines that, okay, there's more text there. Then you can set the width if you wanted to. The same goes for the height. And what should we have here? Let's see. Let's add our first label out. So Command Alt and square braces. And yeah, there we go. We have moved that up there and it looks really nice. And now we want to set the height to be, let's say, 200, to be really noticeable there. Okay, and yeah, that is basically it. Frame, width, and height. And of course, this is the height of our frame because we are having only this one in the vertical stack. And yeah, that is basically it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this one about frames, width, and height. I know it's kind of strange right now because you can't really see the use cases, but just know that they are in there and you can use them at your willing. If you did like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell, because tomorrow we will be talking about dividers and spacers. I know we have kind of touched those in the previous episodes, but we are going to dive deeper into them in the next video. So hit that notification bell to get that new video on your feed. And as always, I will see you in the next one.